Namaskar, Jai Shri Krishna. Manifesting text 45 and text 46 of chapter 9, the passing away of Bhismadeva in the presence of Lord Krishna, first canto creation of Srimad Bhagavatam. Text 45. Tatra dundu bhayo nedura deva manava vaditaha shasham suha sadhavo radnyam khat petuha pushpa vrushtayaha. Thereafter both men and demigods sounded drums in honor, and the honest royal order commenced demonstrations in honor and respect. And from the sky fell showers of flowers. Bhishmadeva was respected both by the human beings and by the demigods. The human beings live on earth and similar other planets in the Bhur and Bhuvar group of planets, but the demigods live in the Swar or heavenly planets, and all of them knew Bhishmadeva as the great warrior and devotee of the Lord. As a Mahajana or authority, he was on the level of Brahma, Narad and Shiv. Although he was a human being, qualification on a par with the great demigods is possible only on attainment of spiritual perfection. Thus, Bhishmadeva was known all over the universes, and during his time, interplanetary travel was effected by finer methods than the futile endeavors of mechanical spacecraft. When the distant planets were informed of the passing away of Bhishmadeva, all the inhabitants of the upper planets as well as of the earth dropped showers of flowers to show due respect to the departed great personality. This showering of flowers from heaven is a sign of recognition by great demigods, and it should never be compared to the decoration of a dead body. The body of Bhishmadeva lost its material effects due to being surcharged with spiritual realization, and thus the body was spiritualized, as when iron becomes red hot when in contact with fire. The body of a fully self-realized soul is not therefore accepted as material. Special ceremonies are observed for such spiritual bodies. The respect and recognition of Bhishmadeva are never to be imitated by artificial means, as it has become a fashion to observe the so-called Jayanti ceremony for any and every common man. According to authorized Shastras, such a Jayanti ceremony for an ordinary man, however exalted he may be materially, is an offense to the Lord, because Jayanti is reserved for the day when the Lord appears on the earth. Bhishmadeva was unique in his activities, and his passing away to the kingdom of God is also unique. Text 46. Tasya niraharanadini samapare tasya bhargava yudhishthiraha karyitva muhurtam dukhito abhavat. O descendant of Bhrugu, Shaunaka, after performing funeral rituals for the dead body of Bhishmadeva, Maharaj Yudhishthir was momentarily overtaken with grief. Bhishmadeva was not only a great family head of Maharaj Yudhishthir, but also he was a great philosopher and friend to him, his brothers and his mother. Since Maharaj Pandu, the father of the five brothers headed by Maharaj Yudhishthir, had died, Bhishmadeva was the most affectionate grandfather of the Pandavas and caretaker of the widow daughter-in-law Kunti Devi. Although Maharaj Dhritarashtra, the elder uncle of Maharaj Yudhishthir, was there to look after them, his affection was more on the side of his 100 sons headed by Duryodhan. Ultimately, a colossal clique was fabricated to deprive the five fatherless brothers of the rightful claim of the kingdom of Hastinapur. There was great intrigue common in imperial palaces, and the five brothers were exiled to the wilderness. But Bhishmadeva was always sincerely sympathetic, well-wisher grandfather, friend and philosopher to Maharaj Yudhishthir, even up to the last moment of his life. He died very happily by seeing Maharaj Yudhishthir to the throne, otherwise he would have long ago quitted his material body instead of suffering agony over the undue sufferings of the Pandavas. He was simply waiting for the opportune moment, because he was sure and certain that the sons of Pandu would come out victorious in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, as his lordship Lord Krishna was their protector. As a devotee of the Lord, he knew that the Lord's devotee cannot be vanquished at any time. Maharaj Yudhishthir was quite aware of all these good wishes of Bhishmadeva, and therefore he must have been feeling the great separation. He was sorry for the separation of a great soul and not for the material body which Bhishmadeva relinquished. The funeral ceremony was a necessary duty, although Bhishmadeva was a liberated soul. Since Bhishmadev was without issue, the eldest grandson, namely Maharaj Yudhishthir, was the rightful person to perform this ceremony. It was a great boon to Bhishmadev that an equally great son of the family undertook the last rites of a great man. Hare Krishna.